Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. This is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Y'all, listen, I'm Elder Corey Mobley. I welcome you to True Vision Church Noonday Prayer Call. I'm so glad that you are here. Y'all, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. The tomb is still empty. So you don't have to worry. Our God is a promise keeper. Do me a favor right now. Like this video, share this video, comment during this prayer time together. Subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already, and follow us on Facebook. Y'all, I'm so excited whenever I think about the goodness of God. And that leads me to ask you this. How are you doing today? What is your I am statement? Type that in right now. If you've joined with us at these noonday prayer calls and our time together online, you know that's one of the things we do here. We ask you how you're doing, and we want it in the form of an I am statement. And then you know what? Name one thing that God has done for you today. For me, He woke me up this morning. And y'all, that gives me inspiration to know that there's still purpose in me. There's still something He sees in me. There's some task He needs me to do. What is one good thing that the Lord has done for you today? What's one thing He's done for you today? Not what He did on yesterday. Not what you plan for Him to do tomorrow. But what has He done for you already today, this morning, early this day? God is good, and He's worthy to be praised. Listen, our devotional time today, our devotional reading is coming from our book. And the title of it is Rest. Rest. The book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 28, is the focus verse today. But we're going to do the Lord's Prayer. We're going to pray for the unemployed. We're going to start it right now by reading our scripture today, Matthew, chapter 11, verse 28. It says this: Come to me, all who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Somebody say amen for the reading today. Let's do our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, Lord God, you've been so good to us. In the season of have and the season of have not, you've always made a way out of no way. God, you've always been right there. You've never left us nor forsaken us. Even when we were in feast, you was right there. When we were in famine, you were right there, guiding us, walking with us, talking with us, reminding us that you love us unconditionally. But Father, right now, there's a need in the house. Someone is unemployed right now. They don't have sufficient income coming in right now. So maybe they are employed, but they're underemployed. That means they're not making enough, Father. They don't feel they're making enough to make ends meet. But Lord, you've always provided. You've always made a way out of no way. You've always got us over the hills and through the valleys and out of the hole. So Father, I ask you right now in the name of Jesus, that those that are unemployed, those that are underemployed, those that are lacking right now in this season, that you be the God, great Jehovah, and you provide for them. You take care of them. I thank you already, God, because when we pray to you, when we put our petitions before you, you are the God of another chance. You are the God that hears our call, hears our prayer, sees our tears. You bottle them up. You take them. Your love for us compels you to take care of us. So, Lord, I know you're going to answer this prayer. I know that you're going to hire. You're going to promote. you're going to give increase. You're going to bless. You're going to work it out. You're going to make good for it. I know this, God, because you've done it over and over again. So it's not that you brought us this far just to leave us. As a matter of fact, you got some more work for us to do. So anyone in the sound of my voice right now that's underemployed or unemployed, God, give it to them right now. Give them back purpose. Give them back peace. Give them back prosperity. Give them back protection. Give them healing of their soul, healing of their mind. Let them know they don't have to walk the floor all night long. They don't have to stress. They don't have to worry. God's going to take care of them as he always has. God, let them not lack for nothing. Gas, meals, clothing, access, money, whatever it is right now, in the name of Jesus, give it to them. Thank you, God. So, Lord, as we end this prayer, our faith has been built up. Our love and our desire to continue to please you has been strengthened. Lord, we thank you right now. We give you hallelujah. We give you praise. Because you are worthy to be praised. It's in the matchless and the majestic name of Jesus the Christ we do pray, our soon coming King. Hallelujah and amen. 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 God bless. God bless. God work it out. God heal. God destroy. God resurrect. God revive. God bless. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.